You're wearing sunscreen. Congrats! You're protecting yourself from the ravages of sunburn. Go you! And if you watched my previous video, you would know SPF is a measure of how well sunscreen protects you from harmful UVB radiation. But UVB isn't the only kind of UV that can damage your skin. Today, we're gonna talk about another type of radiation, UVA, which is further broken down into UVA1 and UVA2. In 1938, a Swiss chemistry student named Franz Greiter climbed Mount Pisbuin and got one hell of a burn, inspiring him to invent one of the first modern sunscreens, and also the sun protection factor, which was great for measuring the UVB absorbing effectiveness of sunscreens. Franz didn't care about no UVA. Here's an interesting fact. UVA rays are used in tanning beds because they can cause the skin to darken, but don't cause visible sunburn. Unfortunately, I also learned in a 2016 study of 63 women diagnosed with melanoma before age 30, 61 of them, or 97%, had used tanning beds. Studies like this are one of the many indicators that UVA is also potentially dangerous. It wasn't until the 80s and 90s that we realized we were only addressing half of the radiation problem. Although UVA radiation isn't the primary cause of sunburn, it still penetrates deeply into the dermis. That's the thick layer of live tissue right below your outer layer of skin. The result? DNA damage that can lead to skin cancer, premature aging, and sunspots on the skin. As countries tried to tackle the challenge of addressing UVA, terms like broad spectrum began to appear on labels, claiming some degree of UVA protection. In the US in 2011, the FDA started using a method called critical wavelength to assess UVA protection. The critical wavelength is the wavelength where 90% of a sunscreen's total UV blocking ability is beneath. To be labeled with broad spectrum protection, the FDA says sunscreens need to have a critical wavelength of 370 nanometers and the test is pass or fail. This method has a few pitfalls. The first is that critical wavelength measures what they call breadth, which in this case is the range between the highest and the lowest wavelengths of absorption. What it doesn't measure is amplitude, or how much of a particular wavelength is being absorbed. It can lead to situations where the UVB absorbance is high, UVA2 is only moderate, and UVA1 is low. So it's possible to be broad spectrum, but offer little overall UVA protection. In fact, situations like this led to the SPF Wars, where SPFs were skyrocketing into the triple digits, while UVA protection remained pretty much the same. Also, because UVA isn't directly tied to a number the way UVB is, there's no way for the consumer to know how much UVA protection they're actually getting. I find that really frustrating. Okay, let's take a closer look at our friends across the pond in Europe. Since 2006, the European Commission has recommended that all sunscreens have a UVA protection factor of at least 1/3 of the SPF and a critical wavelength of at least 370 nanometers. If a sunscreen meets this criteria, it gets a cute little UVA symbol on the package. I really like this approach because it's more transparent. We can easily divide the SPF by 3 to compare the UVA protection provided by the different sunscreens. Man, as an American, I'm jealous. I want that system. If you're in the UK and you buy your sunscreen through Boots, a popular chain of drugstores, they've got their own rating system that uses stars. Who doesn't love stars? As of 1992, sunscreens sold at Boots are required to be labeled for UVA protection according to this rating system, which takes the mean absorbance for the UVA wavelengths and divides them by the mean absorbance for UVB wavelengths. This ratio is then turned into a rating system between 3 and 5 stars. The higher the star rating, the better you're protected against UVA rays. Okay, I like this one even better because it gives you the clearest idea of how much UVA protection you're actually getting, and it requires a much higher standard of protection than even the European recommendation. Us Americans don't like to be outdone, so to avoid falling behind, on February 26, 2019, the US FDA proposed a new rule that would require sunscreens labeled broad spectrum to meet a mean UVA 1 to UV ratio of 0.7 or higher, which is great. I am a huge fan of this method because it emphasizes the UVA 1 wavelengths, which are much, much harder to block than UVA 2 and UVB. And who knows, if the US ever gets access to updated UVA filters like the rest of the world, and with scientists working hard to figure out new sunscreen solutions, maybe one day we'll actually get there. What method was your favorite? And are there any caveats that maybe I didn't discuss that you want to point out? Let me know in the comments. I'd love to hear from you. See you in the next vid.